All right, guys, we're looking at doing a coil replacement here. Furnace is from 2019. Model and serial number of the furnace are tucked right back in there. On this one, we're gonna reuse existing gas line. They got a shutoff valve there, black iron going into the system. So we'll just break it at the union and rebuild it down into the union there, and then rebuild it down into the system. This is a 90 plus efficient system, so it's got its exhaust fluid and PVC outside. I think we'll go ahead and for the customer, we'll take some intake too from the outside, so get fresh air, combustion air from the outside as well. For the return drop, we'll remake a new one. Scratch that, we're gonna leave the existing return drop because we're just doing the AC, so it's just on the supply side here. So we'll have to, we'll set the coil down right on top of the furnace, and then remake a new supply plenum up into the supply ductwork over here. Line set will have to be new because this is not the correct size. Line set comes out of the unit here on the top, goes up into the ceiling, and then runs straight out the wall. So we'll have to put a new line set in for them. And then electrical is okay, that's existing, so we'll go ahead and keep the existing electrical. As far as access goes, you're going to have to bring some tarps because you will be working or walking through the house to bring the equipment downstairs. It's a pretty shallow basement, a short basement, I should say. Electric panel is in the back room over here. And it looks like it's been upgraded to a 200 amp panel, and the air conditioner is one of these top two breakers from what the panel box says. It's one of those top two. Furnace is number 12, so that's right there, 20 amp breaker. And then this is a square D panel box. That should be it down here. Here's the correct model number and serial number for that furnace. Disregard the last one. Here's the outdoor condenser. Here's model and serial number for the condenser. 2.5 ton unit. On this one, like I said, inside we'll be replacing the line set back to the new coil on the inside. We'll put a new disconnect box on. I'm thinking we're probably gonna have to relocate the unit over to the other side of the house just because it's too tight of a spot over here to put our new unit in. So the new unit would most probably be relocated over here. We'd be able to run the line set through the basement over to this location. As far as access goes, it's right around the corner here to on the other side of the garage. There would be access to get in and out of the backyard. They do have a dog back here, so just be careful of letting him out of the house. But here would be the fence. Right on the other side of the fence is the road and the parking area. That should be it for the outside. New condenser here. We're going to be doing a new pad as well whenever we relocate it to the other side of the house. So a new leveling pad, maybe a couple pavers to make sure it's nice and level. That should be it. Oh, I forgot. Our intake is going to be coming out right here next to our exhaust. So that's kind of next to the existing unit, but our intake will come out right next to the exhaust for the existing furnace, right above that window there.